Actually, it was back when I was a kid. Okay, this memory keeps on playing back over and over recently. It's like, I remember when I was a kid, right? I was maybe 5-6 years old, and my mom brought back a huge file, a case file about abused kids. At first, I really didn't know what it was all about. I would just sit there and then look at the photos, and then she explained to me about that there are all these kids out there, right, that are unfortunate, that they are being abused. And here we are, we're thankful that, you know, it doesn't happen in this family. And she taught me that those that we who are able to actually voice up, to actually fight for those who are the voiceless or those who can't, should actually take up that role to preserve, you know, justice in that sense.
I think a lot of it was the role models that she told us to believe in, which is the most prominent one would be Nelson Mandela. His days in prison, 27 years, and his will to always just fight for what is right and for justice really was the inspiration for us. So we read up his book and about his fight, and that really was quite a lot of the driving power to our stance on free and fair elections today.
I think the part that I respect the most respectable trait for her is her willpower. I mean, even with the threats, the death threats and everything else that was happening, the raids on her office, she still stood very strong. Even when her family was being threatened, I mean, if your kids were to be, life were to be threatened, I think you may break. And if I was in her situation, maybe I would not be as strong. And I think that's the most respectable part of her.